We have the pleasure of a personal interview with George Arthur Lareau, a photographic artist who lives in Phoenix, Arizona. Mr. Lareau has just published a book titled, Surreal Bodyscapes. It is a startling collection of artwork that one could say, kickstarts a new photographic genre. These images are different from anything I've ever seen before. Mr. Lareau, I read that your images of nude female models are made with multiple exposures using pinhole cameras. So, I'd like to ask you first about your process for creating these unusual images. How do you do it?
Well, a few things are obvious, like having a studio and having nude models and having some pinhole cameras on hand. But those alone are not enough, because it takes a hellaciously bright flash to squeeze enough light through the camera's tiny pinhole to make an exposure. And that's the expensive part of the process.
I see. Why is it then that you use pinhole cameras for making these images? How is that different from using a camera that has a lens? And here I always thought that a camera had to have a lens, silly me.
To the contrary, the very first camera was a pinhole, a little bitty hole in the wall of a dark room. It projected a picture of what was happening on the other side of the wall, upside down but nevertheless fascinating. These days, pinhole cameras are mostly novelty items. They're made of cheap materials, but there's some that make them fancy, but the only important part of the equation is that the pinhole itself is precisely manufactured, and that is actually the most expensive part of the camera. But it's still cheap. How are they different? Well, for example, one of my pinholes will shoot an extremely wide-angle view, a 120-degree view. That would cost an unthinkable fortune in glass. With that view, I can work close to the model and distort the sides of the image, elongate them, for example. Another of my pinhole cameras is a tin can with an opening for the pinhole. The interesting thing about this camera is that it curves the film so that the image is wrapped in an emerging light, fading away into the black distance.
Okay, I think I understand the difference now. Pinholes allow you to alter perspectives and effects as you shoot. Now, the other important thing about your work is the multiple imaging. How do you do this?
Good question. First, I can't claim that I have total control over the results I get from a shooting session. A certain amount is accidental, but good-looking enough accidents to merit display. My thought process is mostly visualization. I've been a photographer all of my life, off and on, and I see my pictures in my head. The trick with doing multiple exposures, a triple exposure for example, is keeping the three different images together in my head. I can usually do that, but then again, I'm always interested in seeing what I actually shot. But the more I do it, the more often I get what I'm going after.
Tell me, do you have a favorite among the thousands of images you have made?
Yes, my favorite is on the cover of the book.
The book is Surreal Bodyscapes, Pinhole Camera Color Nude Photographs by George Arthur Lareau. It is for sale online at surreal.sufijorg.net, with free inside look. Mr. Lareau, I thank you so much for this interview, and I believe that many art lovers and photographers are also thanking you.
It has been my pleasure.